What's the last topic?
Recurrent.
Be louder.
Recurrent neural
network. What is the need of recurrent neural network? That is what I am saying now. So normally in traditional neural networks, we follow the technique of feed forward, which means that we start with input layer to hidden layer. The output will be given as input to hidden layer. Hidden layer's output will be given as likewise. We will be going in the flow, right? So which will be useful for many kind of applications, right? Neural networks, we have many kind of application, but sometimes there is a need of remembering the previous state's intermediate outputs. So what is the need in the sense? Exactly, I'm saying by example. For example, you are going to translate an English sentence to Tamil. Okay, you are going to translate an English sentence to Tamil. Okay, so you have 5 to 8 words in that sentence. Okay, is it reasonable when you translate each and every word immediately without knowing the meaning or without integrating all the things in the different words? Can we translate like that? You got my point? Can we translate like that? So for example, it is a good day. Likewise, you are having me gift. You are translating for it. Then is, for is you are translating. Good, you are translating. Is it a right way to translate? No, exactly no way. So what is the need here? You have to know the meaning of all the words given in the sentence. You have to store it in your memory. Then you have to interlink all the points, all the words, then you have to translate into some other language. Am I right or not? Right? So the thing is, we have a hidden state or memory state within ourselves to translate as even a single English sentence. Am I right? For example, likewise, many applications, there is a need of, for example, your model has to do like this means, definitely the model also needs some other state, right, to remember all the words. Am I right or not? That is called hidden state or memory state. Okay, which will store the intermediate results from the previous layer also. For example, if it is taking it first means, so it will store the result of it. Okay, it, the meaning of it. Then is likewise one by one it will make and it will store the intermediate previous results also in the memory state or hidden state in order to complete the process. So that is a need for recurrent neural network in widely in speech processing or text processing likewise. Many applications are there. Right? So this is the need of what? Need of recurrent neural network. We need the inputs from previous layer also. Got it? That is the need of recurrent neural network. So we have seen 4 types of recurrent neural network. Hope you remember. What are the types?
1 to 1.
1 to 1.
1 to many.
1 to 1.
Many to
1. Many to many. Different applications we have seen, right? Already. So next, one of the main topic in recurrent neural network is bidirectional recurrent neural network. Bidirectional. From the name itself, we can able to identify the logic. Bidirectional. What is the meaning of bidirectional?
Both the flow,
right? Forward direction, backward direction. So in the previous recurrent neural network, we are taking the output from previous layer alone, okay? But not in both direction. Here, we will be having a hidden state or memory state in order to store the previous layer outputs, and also we can able to process on both the directions, forward direction, backward direction. Okay, so that is the main concept of bidirectional recurrent neural network. So it is a kind of recurrent neural network, right? So it will also store data from earlier steps. Previous steps output will also stored in Got it? determining outputs by integrating the outputs from HT minus 1 forward, HT minus 1 backward. Next is training the model. So these are the steps for bidirectional recurrent neural network. How do you calculate? We have to do some kind of computation, right? In the middle layer, forward and backward. So that computation part is available here. How do you calculate forward? How do you calculate backward? And finally, how do you calculate YT? That is final output. Right? So, listen. So, for every layer, finally, we have to apply an activation function. That you know, right? Activation function. So, that is referred as A here. You have to apply activation function after computation. For example, again, I'm recalling. What do you do? In order to compute?
1 into 0.1.
1 is the input, into is?
Weight.
Plus summation. 2 is the input, into is? This is what we will do, right? Same thing will be applied here also. Listen, after computing this, you will be applying activation function. If bias is available, you will be adding the bias, right? That is what here also we are going to do. Listen, XT is HT forward for current state forward calculation, for current state backward calculation. There is a current state HT here. Forward, backward. Got it? So forward, A is for? I told you, right? A is for?
Activation function.
B louder?
Activation.
Activation function. So can you guess what is this one? PH?
Bias.
Bias. So bias and activation function here, right? Here, right? So next to me. For every stage, current state and previous one will be taken. Minute. So current state in the sense, HT is the current state in the sense. What is the input for HT?
XT.
XT. So XT into S?
Weight.
XH. X is the weight representation. XH. XH. Forward. Forward only we are calculating, right? Forward. Plus. Previous one is
HT
minus 1 forward into weight of forward plus bias. Clear? Shall I repeat or clear? Shall I repeat or clear?
Clear.
Yes. So backward. So this is the backward one, right? This is the backward one, right? So current state is here. You have current state. HT backward is equal to activation function of current one. Current input is XT into its weight. WXH backward. Plus previous. Which one is the previous for backward? Here, this one backward, right? So HT plus 1 is the previous state for backward HT. So that's why here we are taking HT plus 1. Because it is backward. From the backward only you have to take. HT plus 1 backward into its weight plus
bias.
That is the computation for backward and forward. Using this, both the outputs will be integrated in order to get the output of YT HT into weight of Y plus bias. This is the final output, YT. Clear? Clear now? Clear? Listen, this is a simple formula for calculating this part alone. Right? So when you are taking this part means, you have to consider HT plus 2. Am I right? If you are computing HT plus 1, right, means you have to consider HT plus 2. If you are computing HT plus 2 means you have to consider HT plus 3. Likewise, each layer will be processed like this. Got it? Here also back propagation algorithm available. Back propagation is used for finding the errors and eliminating the error using the technique of updation of weights. We will be updating the weight to eliminate the error, right? So here also back propagation algorithm works. It will find out and calculate the error, and the error will be updating the weights. Got it? As usual, same concept. And it has many applications, mainly this bidirectional recurrent neural network is used in sentiment analysis. You know the meaning of sentiment analysis, right? Sometimes a particular statement will be given based on the statement. Sentiment of the statement will be identified. So for example, I'm happy today. I'm happy today means the sentiment of awareness in the statement is happiness. So likewise, sentiment analysis and machine translation, speech recognition, and many kind of speech and explanatory applications can be processed using bidirectional recurrent neural network. Two things you should not forget in bidirectional. One is memory state or inert state, which will be useful for storing the previous outputs, and the second thing is
both the directions.
You will be processing, you will be dividing the hidden layer into two, for forward and backward. That's it. Clear? Take it first. Our next type of recurrent neural network is
deep
recurrent neural network. You know the meaning of and you know the concept of bidirectional, right? One keyword, both the directions, right? Here, the difference between normal recurrent neural network and deep recurrent neural network. Deep means you are going deeper, which means that you have different number of layers, recurrent neural network layers. Large number of recurrent neural network hidden layers available in order to process the application. Deep. Okay? You are going deep in a particular concept, which means that what you are analyzing the concept, you are understanding it, and then you are applying that concept into somewhere, right? So deep you are understanding about the topic. Likewise. So how can you understand it deeply in the sense you have to read again and again, right? Multiple times, and you have to collect lots of data about it, then only you can able to understand deeply. So here also the same concept, deep recurrent means number of layers is large. So we have multiple layers of normal recurrent neural network on top of each other. Large number of normal recurrent network on the whole collectively we are calling it as deep recurrent neural network. Simply I am saying this is, so you are having X1, this H1 alone, or some other 1, 2, 3, for example 1, 2, 3, okay, H1, H2, 3, then output means it is a normal recurrent neural network. But the thing is, there also we have memory state or hidden state to show the output of previous state. Here also we have, but we have large number layers. So H1 itself 1, 2 and so on to any number of layers.